Hi guys, if you look at this is a problem statement given in Analytics Vidya Hackathon. Bank marketing data set. So what is that bank marketing? Is meant for intelligent targeting. So imagine even fixed deposit, even for any kind of loan offers are ready. So they will be targeting. They are ready to give some offer. Even during lockdown, I had a call. A special offer is available right now for the personal loan. 28 lakhs rupees. The maximum approval. So would you like to go for that kind of call comes? So I said, I will note down if there is a need, I will call you like that. I said, it is a kind of customer targeting. You look at any bank, they will have minimum thousands, 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, even the remote banking sector also, they have 40,000 customers. If it is urban, you can't even imagine that city side, especially metropolitan city side, the central place of the city has a bank. You can't even imagine how many will be there. Minimum, to my knowledge, 50,000 customers will be there. Minimum, I'm telling. Maximum, it would go for 1 lakh customers to 2 lakhs customers per bank, I'm telling. Especially public sector bank. So in that case, whom you will promote? That is where data science solution comes. So 1 lakh customer, it is not a joke. It's a great time-consuming effort. Randomly also, I can't pick, I can't sit down. Imagine I'm a telecaller. I need to be advised by the bank manager. What is the scheme has come? What I supposed to articulate? How I need to, that all different story. Then to whom I need to target? That is where the data science solution comes. I hope so you will understand the context of this problem statement. Let it be anything, even loan promotion, fixed deposit promotion, or any kind of special loan offers, home loan offers, personal loan offers, let it be any matter. But I need to target the customer. Finally, they need to come to my dealings, financial dealings. So for that, how can I do? In that situation, really, machine learning is the only solution. So that one of the case study, let us see. Hypothesis writing alone, I will tell. If you wish, I can talk about the coding or everything, pre-processing everything. But right now, only hypothesis. Look at this segment. You have a population. What is population? You will have this problem statement is for marketing campaign. I need to campaign. See, for example, I'm going to give some offer or whatever. I need to go for campaign. I'm rolling out some course. I need to go for campaign. I used to do NPTEL mentorship for the entire college. For the third year and the final year, I will send a mail. I will introduce, I am Dr. Lakshmi so-and-so. I am a mentor for so-and-so. If you wish to take up this NPTEL course, you can register. That is called a campaign. So how can I target? Then after that campaign also, few students came forward and informed me, why, madam, you didn't approach me? I would have joined. Like that, they were approaching. So how I know the students who is really interested for knowledge and inclination, who is not interested, I don't know. See, because 4,000 to 5,000 students population available in our college. Similarly, banking also need to target because it involved with the time, effort and expenditure. Call, how many calls I can call? I can make one per day. So these are all the cumbersome process. We need to resolve this issue. For that, machine learning helps. Look at this case scenario. This is meant for market campaigning among the population. We need to segment. We need to target whom we can approach. How can be done? It can be done with the past record. That past record is what? That is what training data. Past 10 years, 20 years. Though whomever have come for either fixed deposit, whatever, home loan, personal loan, whatever, I would be having their complete detail, marital status, gender, age, then profession, what type of profession he or she is doing, what is the income band, what is the CIBIL score, do whatever you want. So there are records available. Based on that, you will have during the telemarketing itself, campaign itself, you need to note down which are all the telecalls became successful, which are all the telecalls haven't become successful. Only then you can work practice for later. Otherwise, it is not worth enough. So that record, if you have the details, with that, you can segment the population for the future. How you can do campaign next? You can campaign through telephone, radio, TV, social media, anything you can do. Next, promotional strategy. How you need to find out how are potential clients going to be addressed? How you need to address them? Whether really they will become your potential customer or not? So these are all the problem statement. This is called problem statement, title of the problem. These are all the description given to the contest, data description. So this is 16 columns are given for the modeling. ID is for identification. This is what your target variable, term deposit subscribed. Finally, imagine this is a fixed deposit. They call it as term deposit. It may be a fixed deposit. Finally, the customer subscribed or not. After the campaign, whether they subscribed or not is the question. Similarly, in the future, this is called predictive model. You need to predict based on X variable. You need to predict whether that customer will turn to purchase or not, or deposit or not. That's all. Now, if you look at hypothesis writing, when can be done? 1 minute, there's something wrong here. I will look at. Just give me a minute. Yeah. I'll stop sharing this. I'll go to the problem statement or notebook itself, because that I didn't copy it. This is a problem statement. This is a data description, variable description, ID. So these are all the description is given. Educational qualification is important. Based on your education profile only, you can able to subscribe or not. Default. Whether you became a default customer, that is non-paid, some case, some issues. Suppose continuous 6 months, if I am not paying my loan or any of that EMI, whatever, then I'll be termed as a default customer due to any reason. They may give excuse for 2 months or 3 months, I don't know. After that 2 months, 3 months also, we need to go and seek permission. We need to give our letter. So only then you are not treated as a default customer. Without notification, you should not abruptly stop the EMI payment. Then that grace period also 2 to 3 months. After that, if you are not paying back, then definitely you are called as a default customer. So is there any kind of that case is there, that record is there with you or not, default customer or not? So that detail. This is binary type, yes or no. Housing loan, whether you have taken housing loan or personal loan or both of the loan. I do have both of the loan right now. So communication type, how the communication is reached to that customer, day of month. If I start approaching you, why the day of month is important? If I start calling you end of the month for deposit, already you will suffer with a lack of money during the end of the month. Every family, most of the family try to suffer. Then if I approach, definitely you will not turn up. Rather, 15 days before, if I would have called you, then you can think of if the target is for that month, if the target is for next month, I can call you end of the month. So I can ask you to come for this fixed deposit with a high amount of interest. That way I can call you and I can inform you. So that is month. Then day of month, which month contact is made. Then last contact duration. So what is the duration? What is this variable going to give us the indication is, for example, any telecall comes to me for the loan. Maximum I can say monthly 2 calls I used to get from this bank. I don't know where these people are getting my number. They will be eating my head. The bank, which is irrelevant to my bank account also. So what, how I will react? I am busy. I am in meeting. Cut the call. Don't disturb me, don't irritate me. Some kind of, depending upon the mood, I will respond. Imagine if I am really interested for that, my duration will be increased. It is a logically connected. You will also agree. Human tendency, if I am not interested, I'll be cutting the call. There are one or two exceptions are there. For example, a female telecaller, male will be prolonging the conversation for just for spending the time. Or male telecaller, female customer will be prolonging the conversation for just for passing the time. Whatever may be, that is a very exceptional case. Otherwise, any telecaller calls to a person unnecessarily, if the person is not interested, the duration will become shorter. If the person is interested, the duration, conversation duration will become longer, because I would be negotiating. Is there any way to reduce the interest rate for one more person? How much amount you will be trying to give? What are all the procedures? Something like that I will keep investigating, so that the duration will be longer. That is one of the indicator, explaining variable for the prediction, so that that variable is given. Next, number of contacts in campaign. During the current campaign, how many contacts I have established during the call? Number of contacts in the previous campaign and days since previous campaign contact. How many days before I contacted for the previous campaign? Previous campaign outcome, what yes or no, whether that customer turned back or not. Term deposit described. Why I am explaining this all? These all thoroughly understood the domain context. Even I am talking very periphery. Assuming that you are all postgraduate student, I am talking very periphery level. You know, assuming that you know something about banking. Otherwise, I need to speak a lot. We need to investigate lot of time, or we need to spend lot of time on understanding the problem statement and the data set. That is a primary quality of any data scientist, not looking at the model. So from that, we need to formulate a hypothesis. How we are formulating the hypothesis? Hope so you have some background so far now regarding this problem statement. Let us go to the hypothesis generation. Look at what are all the columns done. Look at hypothesis are younger customers more likely to subscribe to the term deposit as compared to the old customer? Prediction. What is the meaning? If I retain the age column, look at age of the person is available, customer age. So if I retain the customer age, naturally I can, that should be one of the independent variable. Customer age should become one of the independent variable. Then I have the rights to claim like this. You can even write or older or middle-aged customers are more likely to subscribe. Anything you can write. Finally, we need to provide the solution. Next, are people with a high bank balance more likely to subscribe for the term deposit? See, bank balance is given. If I have more balance, simply keeping it in the account, I can convert it into fixed deposit. So that is one of the understanding. Does a married person have higher chances to subscribe to a term deposit compared to a single or divorced person? Logically sounds. Normally married people, due to their kids' future or due to their investment or future planning, they will do better. Single, they don't bother about these kind of things. They will be working for the career and they will be waiting for the marriage. Divorced people, they will be in the vexation mode or whatever. So in that common sense, we are claiming. Does the length of the call made to your customer tell us anything about the chance of subscribing? One may think that if the call length is longer, the customer executive has spent a longer time discussing details with the customer. Hence, the customer is more likely to subscribe. Finally, what is the indication is among 15 variable, total 16, one is useless, ID. Never ID will be useful for training the model. While predicting, maybe we can use this ID, we can submit and we can predict. Rest all the variables are independent variable. Term deposit is independent variable, dependent variable. So this also not required. Among rest of all the independent variable, which are all primarily required, that is the indication. One more also you can claim. See, look at the job type. All the white collar, golden collar job, these people definitely will deposit you can claim, or you can claim higher the qualification the person would be coming for the deposit you can claim. Anything, choice is yours. There are two more claims I am proposing other than these four claims. So I can propose the claim that better, otherwise I can combine two. Qualification is better and the job is also white collar job. So in that a lot of job profiles are given. So I can think of anything. Now I can think of any kind of combination, two different combination also I can think of. What is that combination is? Job profile should be higher cadre, bit higher cadre. I belong to white collar job. Similarly, one kind of cadre we can create. The least collar job is black collar. So better collar job. They will be classifying into white collar, black collar, blue collar, then golden collar, something are there. So that golden collar is kind of VIP role or the higher executive role, CEO, these people are coming under golden collar job. So minimum cadre I can fix. So from that people can do not only the collar of the job, also the education is also a matter. I can claim one more hypothesis also. From that hypothesis only, we may need to move for approaching the problem statement. That's all. So this is how you need to write. Your possible view or assertion, then depending upon the accuracy only, you can claim these all. First of all, understand these are all the variable you need to retain in the model building. That is a minimum condition. Second is, this kind of parameters are retained, variables are retained. Any kind of treatment you can do, any kind of model you can do, that is your choice. But these are all the variables should play a role in the prediction or in the classification. That is minimum condition. What is the second condition is, this particular model should give the best accuracy as well as the best F1 score. Sometimes this particular data set which they given completely unbalanced, I can say. 10% of the records are one side, one class. That is class one, subscribed detail. Zero are non-subscribed. So 90% of the data are given in the training data set towards that particular class. 10% of the data only given here. So this, although it is unbalanced, whatever the pre-processing technique I use, it doesn't matter. Finally, these are all the variable mandatorily to be considered for the prediction. So that only then you can claim, you can write. For example, communication is not a matter. How you are trying to communicate is not a matter. I feel so. It has very least influence. So that can be removed. So that only communication, I didn't keep it here. Subscriber, you can come through TV or you can come through phone call or you can come through social media, newspaper advertisement, anything. But that is not a matter, no. Really, if I call you, if you don't have money, will you deposit? Not at all. If you watch TV, will you deposit? Not at all. So communication is not a big challenge, the mode of communication. Finally, what is challenge? Whether you have personal loan, home loan. If you have already two loans, will you go for fixed deposit? I have two loans. I have personal loan also. I have home loan also. If the campaign comes for high interest also, definitely I will not go for term deposit. That are all the prediction. So another hypothesis also I can write or claim. My education is also good enough. My profession is also good enough. However, if I have both loan, definitely I will not go for term deposit. But that is towards negative. Look at that is why that is not written here. Whatever the hypothesis we are writing, why we are trying to predict? For the profitability. When the banker will become profitable, they will be profitable. More subscription goes for the term deposit. For the more subscription only, I need to write the claim. Which are all the claim pulling down? That I should not write. Variables we can consider, because this is the explaining variable. This will explain a lot for the prediction. my home loan, my personal loan will explain very much explanation given to the model by these two variables for the prediction. That is, it is too good. But when it comes for formulating the hypothesis, no negative side we should write, only positive side. That is why I said one more hypothesis, higher qualification. We can look at all the categories of qualification. We can group them up. For example, BTech itself, good qualification. MTech is also good qualification. PhD also good qualification. All those three are available. Let us say, for example, all those three can be combined into one category. I can replace it by one first category. Other qualifications I can look at. I can replace it by another category. All the least qualification or school education level people, I can put it into another category. Then one more is what? Profile, job profile. You can look at all the job profile available also. You can group them up. Two, three kind of professions, similar professions, you can group into one category. Almost teaching level, highest cadre or the highest designation is equivalent to industry level. That level, it has, it can be equated. So that all can be grouped into one category. These two variables essentially to be included. What I am telling, these two, education and qualification, helps for term deposit so that I can write. Whereas another two things, home loan and housing loan, that also help positively. Also I can claim, negatively also I can claim. If I don't have both loan, definitely I will go for depositing. So I can formulate one more hypothesis also. See, I'm right editing now. So what I can edit is, does the customer has home loan enough? Hypothesis cannot be combined more. So next, immediately related hypothesis, does the customer has personal loan? This is also influential parameter, negatively also, positively also. Another claim what I can do is, does the customer has highest qualification? Whatever the parameter you are retaining for the prediction, all those parameter we need to understand, will it make sense for the prediction or not, then we can write the hypothesis. That's all. Now instead of that four hypothesis, now it became six hypothesis, almost not six. Yeah, seven hypothesis. It became seven hypothesis. So this is how we need to write hypothesis for the machine learning problem. Those hypotheses which I have written for statistical related problem. When you need to use statistics, when number of samples are countable, like 100, like 150, those situation you can go for. There is ANOVA test, analysis of variance. Anything you can use depending upon the number of samples and size of the sample. Number of samples are what? Number of comparison study. Then size of the sample is number of records. When it comes here, it is not the sample analysis. I am not going to compare. So this is kind of prediction problem. Within the given set of data, we need to consider for training and we need to take a new set of data which are all not available, placed in the training data set. I can give it to the machine or the model. It will be in the position to predict. If it is numerical prediction, that is called regression. If it is categorical prediction, it is called classification. Both fall into prediction category only. Classification is also prediction data type. That is supervised learning. And regression is also prediction data, prediction model. It also fall into supervised learning. But the way it predicts only different. Your target variable or Y variable is of continuous value. That means integer value, float value, anything in numerical, if you are in the position to predict, you need to prefer regression. any type of regression. Regression also has many types. If the target variable or Y variable is of the type categorical, then you need to prefer any one of the classification model. Classification also several models available. So many models available. So these are all the way. But both fall into trend analysis or prediction or supervised learning. That's all. So when it comes machine learning, how we supposed to write a hypothesis is this. When it comes statistics, writing hypothesis is very little bit simpler than this. I can say simpler. So two hypotheses I have exhibited to you. This also over, the previous hypothesis also over. Let us walk through few more problem for t-test. So with that, I am closing this one, not walking through the notebook. Let us go for where we stopped. So this is the variance of t-test we have seen. One sample, only one class. Just I am giving recap. When to use one tail. Whenever you compare less than greater than. What is less than greater than? Look at any normal distribution. This always you need to refer this middle point. Look at this, this mean. Right hand side if you think of analyzing, that is called greater than. Look at this dotted line. Left hand side if you are analyzing, it is called lesser. Whenever less than or greater than analysis you are trying to do, it is called one tail. Why it is called one tail? See, look at, if I say the problem to find out for greater, you will be looking at this normal distribution bell curve on the right side. So that it is called one tail. You are not bothered about this. For example, the class average mark, your class mark average is, let us say 65%. I want to find out the probability of your class in the higher than 65 marks. I want to focus on only the creamy layer. I want to focus on only excellent students. Those who have got other than or above 65, I want to calculate the probability or area under this portion. After this dotted line till this tail, one of you you have a chance to get 100 out of 100 also. You will come here extreme, 100 out of 100, you will come extreme of the tail. That is fine. So I want to calculate the area of this portion. Whenever I find out area of this portion, it is related with the operation called greater than. You need to see the word greater than. The moment you see the word greater than, you need to focus on the normal distribution curve on this side. Whenever you see the less than, I want to similarly find out the probability of getting mark whomever may be less than 65 from your class. One of you may get zero also, fine. But I want to calculate probability of getting less than this mean average. This is the mean or this is the average. Less than this, then I'll be looking into this area. Look at here, one dark color is there. If I want to calculate like this, for example, this is the area maybe for 90 marks. I want to calculate the probability of persons who are all trying to get more than 90 marks in this particular class. So this is the tail. More than 90, definitely it would be very less. In every class, it will become very less, negligible. Very few people only will try to get more than 90. So that I want to calculate only this area. This area is meant for more than 90. Hope so you will understand. Next, this is called one tail. What is called two tail? What is two tail is, I want to calculate greater than 80 students are probability, less than 30 probability. Both end I am trying to do equal to. Whenever equal to, if I get that equal to comes into the picture, is called two tail. Equal to is related to two tail. I need to work on both tail, then I need to add, sum it up. this area I need to calculate and I need to submit up. This is the indication for two tail. In the English vocabulary of the problem, if you could see equal to, you need to use two. 1 minute. It is not moving. Yeah, let us write here. Equal to, any moment you see, equal to or not equal to. These are all the problems. Whenever you are looking in the problem statement, these all related to two tail. Both of the tail you need to consider in that normal distribution. The moment I say tail, you need to visualize always normal distribution curve. Next, whenever you see the problem statement with the word greater or lesser, greater than or equal to, these are all the words. If you could notice, then you need to understand this is single tail, one tail, anything word you can use. So this is how you need to understand the problem statement. This is another thumb rule I'm trying to give you. So equal to, not equal to, related to two tail. Greater or lesser, related to one tail. That's all. If you understand this, more than enough. Let us go back. See, final p value is calculated. Probability value combining both sides of the distribution. Now let us consider one of the problem. Process control at a call center. Performance of a call center is monitored by the average call duration. Data from 18 months we have collected. We need to monitor for the call duration. Average call duration is 4 minutes. Standard deviation is 3 minutes. Cannot monitor each and every call due to limited resource. So randomly sampled 50 calls per day only we are going to sample. This is the given problem statement. Nothing more is given. Look at, this is called 20. It is mentioned, 1 minute, I'll bring 18 months, no? Date from 18 months. So instead of 18 months, let us imagine 20 months. Let us imagine this is 20 months. 20 months call duration, average and standard deviation we do have. This is instead of day one, imagine month. This is month. Let us forget about this. Let us relate it to month. One minute. This also not suits. This is related to month. Imagine this is month. This instead of day, you need to imagine month, that's all. So now this is the problem statement. We need to find out why we are analyzing this. You may ask one more question. See, if it is BPO, call center or KPO, these are all those people always responding or communicating with the customer. So pipelining. How much time every customer call can be spent? If it is spent more, there is a lot of issues. Understand, this is a very potential problem statement related to BPO. Whenever call duration goes more, there is something wrong in the system, in that business itself. Call duration normally should not go more than 3 minutes or 4 minutes. So that is normal understanding, even common sense through, not only statistics through. If it is going more, there are two issues. One is handling the calls will become delayed. Customers' frustration will become more. They will not get the line. Needs to be cleared. Number two, manpower, personal management. How many calls a person can attend per day? Because duration is also a matter. I need to substitute one more telecaller also for the customer care or customer services helpline. So this is second one I will get insight. Number three, sometime the call duration goes more than 4 minutes, something wrong. That wrong can be any way. the telecaller simply wasting time in calling her friends or talking with her friends or family members for the longer duration. She's or he are not into the proper duty. That is one indication. Another indication is the call duration is more when people will call, talk more during the customer call services. There should be a problem that is not at all solved by the people. There is a big issue. So that are all the member or those are all the member will be speaking for longer duration. So this is another matter, sensitive matter, need to be taken care. These are all the four use cases of why we are analyzing this problem. Not for academics. I can say this is for academics example for this problem. But real time when it comes, because your subject is business analytics, you need to understand why we should use these statistics, where we need to use. This is not a statistics paper, simply learning mathematical formula and going away. This is business analytics, understanding the importance of the subject. So that is the reason we need to find out, we need to go for statistical test on this data. For any four reason, any one of the four reasons or all the four reasons maybe. That is why this problem statement we are having, we are going to work on it. Now let us consider, see, given this, what is the meaning? Average call should become 4 minutes. Standard deviation not at all record for us for discussion. Now you need to tell me what test I should use. This is called, imagine month wise. Data from 20 months shows. So 20 months, imagine this is 10th month, average mean call duration we can have, or day also. Instead of month, I can say data from 20 days also I can write, because 20 days data I have. So I need to find out in a particular day, is there anything wrong happened? Is there anything to be noticed? Like that I need to find out. So that is the problem objective. Now the question is, just now we have seen the quick recap. What is the type of test I need to do for this problem statement? You can communicate in the chat window. What is the type of test I can do? T-test, that is fine, fantastic. Again, T-test, two types, no? Because it's sampling, so that it is t-test, fine. Now, what is the type of t-test I need to use? Just know the revision I gave, clue I have given. Before stepping into the problem, I had given you the clue, no? What is the type of t-test we need to use is the question now. No, 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 type of t-test, don't write alternative and all. That is when we form the hypothesis only, we need to decide what to be right, what to be written. Every problem we need to write both null hypothesis, alternate hypothesis. Type of test we need to use is the question. See, I have written. There is no use of your interpretation. Completely, I have given you the clue. Guys, no one is ready to think. What is the type of t-test we need to use? If I give you your clue, then problem will be away. This is the problem statement. For this problem only, I had given you the quick recap. When to use, what test, why to use. Are you there? Anyone? 801? 803? Are you there, or guys? Or not? 804?
Okay.
Trying to give answer, why are you are unmuting? Yeah, where is the answer? 1, 3, 4. Where is the answer? At least 5 started threading with a t-test. How about others? What is the type of t-test? Not even single one you guys are giving answer. I'm surprised after giving explanation also. One sample, fine. Then final, bit by bit only you guys will give one sample test. That is fantastic, right? One tail. Yeah, now only you people are coming to the point. One sample, two tail. I said now, look at this. Equal to whenever you see what I said. Greater clue itself I had given you. What is the problem statement it is given? Mu should become equal to. I didn't give greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. Exactly it is equal to. Mean. You need to look at the mean value. It is a two-tail test problem. That is fine. Now let us go how to solve the problem. Because understanding what test you need to use is a challenging question here. Once if you know the test, then there is no more thing. Only formula, plugging in, doing calculation, using calculator or Excel or anything. No more duty for you. Look at sample size is 20, days are 20, whatever. Sample size is 50. In that given is sample size is 50. Then days are 20. Here look at days are 20. Next, 10th day. We need to verify each and every day which day something had gone wrong. See, especially we need to verify for 7.2 something fishy, 6.1, 6.5, 5.3. These are all fishy things. We need to verify especially here. Rather than for example, this all you can do it as an assignment statement. Later on, the same problem I'll give you, do for assignment. Now, 10th day we are going to pick up for solving the problem. What is the call duration? 4.6. This is also something fishy. See, because call duration must be 4 minutes. If it is more than 4 minutes, there is something issue. We need to take necessary steps. Always remember, null hypothesis will not encourage anything to take decision. If you want to take decision, it won't encourage. It won't encourage. So mu equal to 4. Next, if it is 4, what is the meaning? There is no wrong is happening. The call duration is 4 means everything going good. You no need to pay any attention. You no need to hire any people. That 4 problem I said. All the 4 problem you no need to consider at all. You no need to bother at all. 4 problems. So when we need to be careful is something goes wrong. When it will go wrong. If the call duration is average call duration is go more than 4. There is something wrong. Then we need to take a lot of things. What are all the 4 problem I said? Customer delay is increased. Call duration is more. Customer service will be increased. The customer will get frustration. So customer satisfaction is more important. That is why customer care service is available. Number 2. Person in the desk is not sufficient. I need to appoint some more. So for that I need to calculate. Are more than 4 minutes means something positive also can go, something negative also can go, or something unusual is happening. I need to take decision. For that, we need to take care of all those things. If it is 4, there is no interesting. It's going quite comfortable, good or bad, it's going well. So it will not discourage, it will not encourage. That always you need to put it in the H not. Not equal to 4. Something different thing. It is not 4. Either it may be lesser or it may be greater. It doesn't matter, but not 4. We need to take some decision. So always when we need to take decision, we need to put it in the alternative hypothesis. if it is less than or more than 4 minutes are not to be considered. That's all. So here when the process is out of control, we need to take decision. H not will not encourage for the decision. HA will allow us to take decision. Always HA only will allow us for taking decision. That's all. This is how hypothesis you need to formulate. This is the step given by 805, but well advanced. I was asking first what type of test. So that was well advanced. See, look at one sample, two tail test. It is related to one sample, two tail test. This is the problem statement, not test. It is a test only. It is right only. Let it be. So finally, we arrived. What is the problem statement? Now, next, what we need to do? T-test. That is given or you guys predicted earlier. Now, T-test. X bar minus mu S divided by square root of N. You need to plug in. 4.6 is the X bar because 10th day, what we have considered? 4.6. This is the average value. Look at the title itself, mean. Mean call duration. So that mean value substitution is 4.6 minus mu with respect to whom we need to compare. In the given problem statement itself 4. So that minus mu x bar minus mu divided by s divided by square root of n. N is average of 50 samples. It is given. So s is 3. Look at here. Here 1 minute. So instead of a sigma problem statement, either it will be sigma or S. We need to interpret depending upon the problem statement context. So S is 3. 3 minutes, sample is 50. Imagine per call average is for 50 calls. This is the average for 50 call. This is for 50 call. This is for 50 calls. So that 50 we have substituted. That's all. The obtained value of T is 1.4. T value, we need to find out probability value or P value. How we can calculate for the one tail, PT is a command in R. PT of 1.4, degrees of freedom. 50 is the number or size of the sample. Degrees of freedom is N minus 1. So 49 is substituted. This is PT. This is for finding out one side or that greater than tail. Whenever greater than tail is calculated, no command available in R, so that we need to calculate 1 minus. If we know one end of this tail, look at this graph. This is the greater than tail. If I know this tail, the same distribution or probability only on this side also. So I can multiply by 2. Instead, R language will not allow us to calculate for greater than side and will allow us to calculate for less than side. So that 1 minus we are doing into 2. Both of the side probability will become same. Here, any because area under this curve is 1, it looks symmetry. One end if we know, other end easily we can calculate. That is the reason, because of the convenience of R usage, we are calculating for the right tail, right hand side, right tail using PT command, but it is not possible. So left tail, if you want to calculate 1 minus, you need to put then 2 into because 2 tail. Already I said P value is summation of P1 plus P2. This is both end you need to do, or else you can do this 2 times. 2 into this addition. One side of the p value is this. If you want to calculate another side, it is symmetric proportion. So you can put 2 into. Finally, you will get this answer. Now, alpha level. Choice is yours. You can fix 90%, 95%, usually 95%. So alpha equal to 0.05. Compare this. This is decision rule. You need to take decision. This is not less than this. No. So we accept H naught or null hypothesis. Less than this. It is not at all less than this. 1 minute. 0.16 is less than 6. No, it is greater than. 1 is greater than 0.05. Yeah, 1 minute. We reject H naught. We reject H naught. See, look at 0.16 is greater. You can calculate using R also. Calculate it, then come out. This is 1.4. This is calculated already. Now, reject H naught or accept alternative hypothesis. That's all. This indicates process is not under the control. So, need of tracing the root cause of the delay. Instead of this, I need to write, need to improve the process. There is a delay. It says, look at, through our common sense itself, we can take decision. 4.6 crossed. The value itself is 4.6. Given is 4 minutes. Through statistically also, it is proved. It is going 1.6 is greater than it is. We reject H naught. When we can accept H naught? If it is equal only, we need to accept. It is not at all equal. So definitely it is not at all equal to 4. So that we need to accept alternate hypothesis. Something, so need of tracing the root cause for the delay is essential. This all into business case. Now we can't do anything. Need to improve the process. This is the recommendation given by the statistician to the officer. Then officer need to diagnose and find out. So this is the command, normal command for two-sided. The few tips I am giving for Excel command. This is meant for two sample test. Now we move on to one more problem. With that we will stop. We need to understand the problem also. Another example. An outbreak of salmonella related illness was attributed to ice cream produced at a certain factory. Scientists measured the level of salmonella in 9 randomly sampled batches of ice cream. The levels in MPNG, this is the measurement, grams, where these are all the measured grams. What is this? I'll tell you. I'll give the brief of the context. First, context and understanding is essential. Salmonella is a kind of bacteria, intestine related bacteria. If this bacteria goes, there would be some problem, stomach pain, anything, something people will suffer. Any kind of digestion related issue or excretion related issue, people will suffer. So this is the kind of bacteria. Salmonella will be available in few of the food product due to anything, unhygiene or due to expiry or whatever may be the process. So imagine there is an ice cream factory or producer. Their scientist measured the level of salmonella in 9 randomly sampled batches of the ice cream. So every weekly once I am going for inspection. Let us imagine I am the health inspector. So or else food and beverages inspection team. So I am going for this kind of verification. By that time the level of this I am measuring. What is this measuring is fine. From the doctor or physician, I need to get advice. What they are telling, is there evidence that the mean level of salmonella in the ice cream is greater than? If anybody has 0.03 MNPG and above, they will get into serious issue. What is the kind of issue? Digestion related or this bacteria related issue. So they themselves given this threshold value. Look at what is the keyword? I myself heightened. Now you need to tell me what is the type of test we need to use for this problem. One tile, fantastic. So what is one tile is greater than only, because that is very danger zone they are indicating. If it is more than 0.3, it is not good for health. So that is one end, right side of the tail comes into the picture. So that one sample, one tail test we supposed to do. This is the final conclusion. So now let us proceed. Hypothesis formulation, if it is less than, it won't encourage, na? There is no issue that factory doesn't have any problem. Those who are all eating that ice cream also don't have any problem. We can proceed with greater than 30 only we need to take action so that it encourages, this discourages. So next is mu equal to this, s is equal to this, just noting down all the parameters from the given problem. Next, what you are trying to do, substitute x bar minus mu divided by s divided by s into square root of n. There is a shadow in it, that's all. So substitute these all. So when you substitute, x bar is this, mu is what, 0.3, they themselves fixed that from the physician, I said from the doctor, this is mu greater than mean level of salmonella should become greater than less than 3. So that it is given 3 divided by s, 0.2125. This you need to calculate from this data. S value, sample variance, you need to calculate from the given data. You need to use the variance formula. So that is available. Next is what? N. Number of square root of n. 0.21 divided by 3, how come, 1 minute, square root of n is 3, correct? Why square root of the n? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Square root of 9 is what? 3. So that it is available 3. That's all. You can calculate this. From this, degrees of freedom would become 8. You need to find out the probability value. This is t value. After this probability value, how you can find out? You need to go for pt. Pt of 2.2055, in our language I am telling, degrees of freedom 8, small pt. This is the command. If you execute in R, you will get the output what is available here. Then compare this. Reject the null hypothesis. Why we are comparing? No. This one we cannot compare. We need to compare with significance level, 0.05. So when we are comparing, this is greater. 1 minute. This we should not consider. We need to compare. I'll write down here. So how we can compare? 1.860. is less than 0.05. This is the confidence level. No, it is not less than. Is this is less than? Is it true? Is the question. Not at all. No. Then we need to go for alternate hypothesis. What is this alternative hypothesis? Salmonella control, that bacteria control is exceeded by the health inspection or whatever, the value given by the health inspector, whatever. So then we need to moderately strong evidence that the mean salmonella level in the ice cream is above 0.3. Now, whatever the action you want to take, you can take. That's all. This is the final conclusion. So alternate hypothesis is the level of bacteria. I should not write bacteria. That same salmonella only I need to write. A level of that is beyond the given mean level, that is 0.3. It is necessary to take action on the producer, or the instruction or circular need to be sent to the producers to reduce the salmonella level less than 3. Whatever, either you can put a seal. reduce this salmonella level or control. Actually, one-on-one if we do, there will not be any problem. So several samples in the same factory for periodically, weekly once or 2 days alternative or once for 2 days if you are reading and taking, then only you can go for controlling. Otherwise, individually looking at, we ourselves can take decision. See, this has some serious issue. This doesn't have any issue. This relatively higher, but we can accept. So this one serious issue, no issue, serious matter, relatively higher, but no big issue. This is also. Look at, except these two, no other day the salmonella level is higher. Salmonella level is lower, except these two, all other are higher. So naturally, it should go to alternate hypothesis only. Something serious, we need to take action. That's all. So that statistically we are proving level is greater than this is so we need to write the conclusion. So this is conclusion or advice or recommendation. Solving the problem, we should be, since it is business analytics, you should be in the position to advise to the business or any kind of the related officials. So this is how we need to give the interpretation to the officials after doing this particular analysis. That's all, guys. So with that, look at p-value, this degrees of freedom, alternate hypothesis, this p-value is this, moderately strong evidence in the ice cream is above this. That's all. So there is one more problem. We can go ahead with that. We can complete, or you can try by yourself. I just give the notification. I give the brief or background about this problem. Look at, 6 subjects were given a drug. That means 6 members. So they will call medical terminology 6 subjects. One is treatment group. Another one is control group. What is that placebo effect they used to tell? What is that placebo effect? I'll tell you. Normally, placebo effect in most of the medical practices they used to do. What is the meaning is pseudo-medicine. Pseudo-medicine is actually they will invent one medicine. They'll take two same patient. For example, little bit we can say serious disease like corona itself, let us take. So there is a medicine available. Let us imagine. Or I am giving some antibiotic. So one is control group, one is treatment group. 6 members, I need to take equal size. One antibiotic I'm trying to give for this group. This group I'll give some medicine, not antibiotics. That medicine may be something, some digestive tablet or something like that. Or anything I can, if it is tube tablet, then I can fill that tablet with some food products. Rice flour, I can fill with rice flour. That patient don't know what is there in it. Only the physician knows that what is in it. It will be given for both. Placebo group also assume that they are taking that medicine which is really introduced in the market or that antibiotic. Treatment group really treated with that medicine. So I need to observe these two patients, group of patients. Placebo effect is pseudo medicine, understand. Normally this research all the physicians will do. What is the meaning that a pseudo medicine? No. Homeopathic they used to do. They will test your whether the disease is caused by the emotional factor or by your biological factor. They will be verified. So in front of you, they will give some medicine. That medicine is not at all a real medicine. Something like they will falsify you. You will think that you are taking that medicine. This much we should not talk more. Sufficient. So that is placebo medicine or effect. So that kind of research people used to do in the medical field. So this is control group. So the treatment observation, maybe number of days recovery or say reaction time to stimulus was measured, how when the medicine reaction started, something like that they will be recording. Then we need to go for statistical analysis whether that this medicine is working, drug is working well, or placebo effect is working well. We need to analyze. This is famous problem. Any statistic you go know, they will teach this problem. Control group. This is the time of reaction started because of the drug. This is placebo group. Time of reaction started for the placebo group. That placebo reading also available. Now look at what is the word we need to capture. Comparing measured treatment group to sample. Okay, fine. No clue is given in this. None of the clue greater than equal to none of the clue is given. Look at, we need to find out the mean value of this. We need to find out the mean value for this. Similarly, we can find out variance for this, variance for this. Because no other straightforward parameters are given for our problem proceeding. We need to formulate the hypothesis, H naught. Null hypothesis, mu control equal to mu treatment. What is the meaning? There is no big difference between both of the medicine. 1 minute now. There is no big difference between, that is the meaning, both of the medicines. That is the meaning. What this says, there is a difference. We can try with 3 different tablets also. These kind of statistics, they will observe the reading of the patients with 3 different tablets or drugs. Drug A, drug B, drug C. When the moment 3 samples, we can go for only analysis of variants. Now we can do with 2 samples, we can do with t-test. So we need to equal, we are claiming not equal. The moment I use equal or not equal, this is related to 2-sample, 2-tail test. This is a conclusion we need to take. So 2-sample, 2-tail. This is 1 sample, this is 1 sample. Now we can proceed with calculation. First, you need to calculate T value. See, this is how you can calculate T value in R. So go for control, go for treatment, then go for feeding these 2 array of elements. Then alternative is 2-sided because we are going for 2-tail test. So 2-sided. So hypothesis C, mu 1 is equal to, both are 0, there is no difference. Both are not equal to 0, there is a difference. Either way you can formulate. And next is t-test, control group, treatment. Then after finding t-value, degrees of freedom, p-value. Degrees of freedom, it is not directly to this 3. It is different. I'll tell you. This is the R output. You can get R output. If you want to calculate the degrees of freedom for this case, especially this kind of problem, you can refer this material for calculating. If you want to know more, otherwise R will do for you. It will take automatically degrees of freedom by itself. So p-value you will be getting. After getting the p-value, you need to calculate p-value. First you are going for t-test. After this, output of this would become this. Then you can consider the degrees of freedom. Then you can go for the p-value. So this is the output of Welk 2-sample t-test. So this is how you need to interpret, given the problem statement, how we need to take it further and what type of test. So after the examination, if time permits, I will discuss with ANOVA.